नमस्कार, आभार, अभिनंदन. गुड इवनिंग शिवम. और कैसे हैं हम? हाउ आर वी? हाउ आर द थिंग्स? विश यू ऑल ए वेरी हैप्पी नवरात्रि. गुड इवनिंग ज्योत्सना. दांडिया करो शिवम भाई. गुड. गुड इवनिंग राधिका. आई थिंक पीपल लेफ्ट टुडे. दे डिड नॉट फेल्ट लाइक. आई सेड ओके, ऑल ऑफ देम एब्सकॉन्डिंग. आई थॉट ऑफ, बट नाउ पीपल आर इमर्जिंग स्लोली. गुड इवनिंग नौशीन. स्मरणिका, गुड इवनिंग. वेयर वर यू स्मरणिका? नॉट टू बी सीन एट ऑल फॉर लॉन्ग 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 टाइम. गुड इवनिंग सर जी. दिव्यांश, सो ऑल ऑफ यू विश यू ऑल ऑफ यू वेरी हैप्पी नवरात्रि. लेट गॉडेस ऑफ एनर्जी गिव यू स्ट्रेंथ, ऑल द सक्सेस. यू शुड रीच टू द टॉप ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. यू शुड गेट वॉट यू डिजर्व, राइट? So with this note, let us start the day. Tamanna, good evening. Structural organization in animal, the second time, the second session has been allotted to it. Good evening, Arun, Yogesh. And first class we did about epithelial tissues, and I hope you people have done good in CPP. Coming to the second part of it, which includes connective tissue, muscular and neural tissues, we are talking only about the anatomy. Do remember it. We are not going to the detail of it. So what we discussed earlier was epithelial tissue structure and function. Nausheen, Tamanna and all my beloved dears, wish you all a very happy Navratri. Okay. Today we will be talking about connective tissue, muscular tissue and neurons, neural tissues, all in a nutshell. I'll do detail about connective tissue, muscular and neural. I'll do in nutshell, because when you talk about neural coordination, you will be reading in detail. When you talk about muscle contraction, you will be reading about muscles in detail. But connective tissue, by default, we don't get a place other than the in circulatory system, little bit about blood, because blood is a fluid connective tissue. This is the question that most of you, my beloved, have people have done it wrong. Hairs present on the skin are, do remember, they all of them are epidermal in origin and made up of dead cells. That's the reason whenever we cut the hairs, it never pains. But whenever we pull the hairs, it pains. Why, sir? Because we have something called as hair follicle. This is the hair. This is hair follicle. So when you pull, so you can always see a root. So when you pull anything from the root, it is painful. And that's the reason always I say, students, hair and nails are dead. Most of us has this confusion, you know, sir, they are non-living. My dears and ears, difference between non-living and dead is which have had life. Anything which have had life is dead. Non-living, no life, never. What I am holding is non-living. That's the reason we have called it as dead body. The body which had life, now it is dead. So starting the class, as we have last time discussed in detail about epithelial tissue, today we'll be talking about nervous tissue, muscular tissue, along with that connective tissue, loose connective tissue, bone, cartilage, and the fluid connective tissue, that is blood, which is a liquid matrix. Sir, the following types of connective tissues that has been covered in this activity, what we are going to do today. Loose areolar connective tissue, delicate thin layers between tissues present in all mucous membranes. That is the reason whenever you pull the hairs of your nose or you sneeze, they're very delicate. Just below the skin, you get this loose areolar connective tissues. Adipose tissues, that is the fat. Dense connective tissues, tendons and ligaments. I hope you know, all of you are writing for PMT, pre-medical test. In place of P, write B. So when you write B, it becomes bone and muscles are joined by tendons. That's the formula. KPL, Pro-Kabaddi League is on. BPL TV was there. Now you have BBL, bone, and bone is joined by ligament. This is the formula. BMT and BBL. Bone and bone is joined by ligament, bone and muscle is tendon. That's the reason you will always see people say ligament tear. You never listen people telling they have a tendon tear. Because ligament is bone to bone. Usually those athletes and all, ankle twist. Hyaline cartilage, nose, ends of long bones, ribs. This is the hyaline cartilage. Elastic cartilage, outer ear, epiglottis. Inside you might see when you open broad open the mouth, that end of the throat, you will see something, this is hanging. This is epiglottis. Fibrocartilage between vertebrae, knee joints, pubic joints. Bones, skeletal system, blood, bloodstream. This is what we are trying to cover, all these things. Good evening, Sunil. Sir, entire connective tissue, I'm talking about only connective tissue, I'll starting with start entire connective tissue has a embryonic origin called as mesenchyme. Mesenchyme, if you remember, it is like a fibrous very thin layer. It is divided into four different type of cellular lines. One is called as hematopoietic stem cells, which you call it as stem cells of blood. Osteoblast, chondroblast, fibroblast. Do remember, all the blast only gives rise to sight. Don't make it other way. Whatever is blast is that will give rise to sight. Osteoblast will give rise to osteocyte. Chondroblast will give rise to chondrocyte. Fibroblast will give rise to fibrocytes. Fibroblast, fibrocytes, chondrocytes, osteocytes, blood cells and macrophages. So what does it make? Fibrocytes, they make proper connective tissue. Chondrocytes, as the name says, cartilages. Osteocytes, osseous, osseous means bones, and as I told earlier, hematopoietic means blood. What subclasses? Connective tissue proper, loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue. This loose connective tissue and dense connective tissues, they, when you say loose, they are just below the surface. Adipose, fat, and network-like structure, that is reticulate. Reticulate means network-like. Whereas dense connective tissues is made up of rye, regular or irregular or elastic. Examples will come. Cartilage, hyaline cartilage, fibrocartilage, elastic cartilage. Compact bone, spongy bone, that is called as cancellous bone. Achondroplasia, in which cartilages are absent, or cartilage shrunk, Radhika, that is called as achondroplasia. Okay. When you say tissue class, the connective tissues proper, loose connective tissue, areolar, adipose, radicular, fibroblast cells, fibrocytes, defense cells, fat cells, vary in density and type of fibers, functions as a binding tissue, very important. Connective tissue proper act as a binding tissue, resist mechanical stress, particular tensions. Collagen reticular elastic gel like substances, that is a matrix. So do remember, when we're talking about the connective, there should always be a matrix. Without matrix, connective tissue cannot work. Cartilage, hyaline cartilage, elastic cartilage, fibrocartilage. This is the example of a picture of a hyaline cartilage. This is the picture of a dense regular connective tissue. Again, here also matrix is the same, except the reticular ones. Here you will not find reticular matrix. As it is said, chondrocytes, because they are the basis. Chondroblast found in growing cartilage gives rise to chondrocytes. Resist compression because of the large amount of water held in the matrix. It resists the compression. That is a very important thing. Best is ears, you can see. Functions to cushion and support body structures. So in your body, it's not only bones that are responsible, even cartilages are equally responsible. Then comes bone tissues and blood. This is the example of compact bone or the spongy bone. Compact bone, osteoblast, spongy bone, osteocytes, same, fiber is collagen. Support functions, compression, resistance, it resists both compression as well as tension. Do remember, direct questions are asked from this section. Hardly any question is there on analysis of it. Fact-based questions are asked, what is what, either match the following. And I'll tell you where the twist question will be asked, I'll let you know. Blood cells formation and differentiation quite complex. Erythrocyte, leukocyte, platelets, plasma, no fibers, a fluid tissue. Functions to carry oxygen, carbon dioxide. And I think Dr. Khushbu is doing that respiratory system with you people. So it will be easy for you people to understand that better. Whatever I am doing is a reverse engineering. So when we say connective tissue proper, loose connective tissue, areolar. If you see the diagram or picture, it is a soft packaging tissue. This is elastic fiber. Collagen fiber. Fibroblast nuclei. So if you see, these are the gel-like matrix. And when I say these are the gel-like matrix, the most important thing you should always remember. They wrap and cushion the organs. It's macrophages. Phagocytized bacteria plays important role in inflammation, holds to convey tissue fluid. Very important. Very important. Try to understand it. Right now, where they are located. So most important, if you understand the location, it is better. Widely distributed under epithelia of the body, that's I told you, areolar. Mucous membranes, package organs, surround capillaries. Yes, Naushin, that is the reason our teachers used to hold our ears and twist it. We used to get a pain, they get the happiness. Yeah, Jyotsna, correct. Cartilage, that's the reason. Na. Your teacher used to twist. And to the kids also, we tell them, oh, so sweet. We do to the nose because we feel it will not harm. But technically, it pains. So, always remember, anything which is very soft, no, Radhika, Jyotsna, I think they are telling the meaning of pliable. Pliable means, yes, which can be twisted. It can, you can't call it as flexible. Flexible is different, pliable is different. So if you see the detailed structure of it, macrophages, fibroblasts, lymphocytes, fat cells, mast cells. And if you see here, these are the mast cells that are responsible for allergic reactions. This is important. You can see here collagen fiber, elastic fiber, reticular fibers, all the three. You see this thick one is collagen fibers. Elastic fibers is brown color structure. Whereas, what you call it as, reticular fibers are this, which are on the base molecule. Coming to adipose, adipose means fats, as you know. in case of mammary glands. They are present under the skin in hypodermis, whereas areolar was not in hypodermis. Try to understand that. Provides reserve food fuels, insulates against heat loss, supports and protects organs. Matrix as in areolar, but very sparse. Closely packed adipocytes, fat cells, have nucleus pushed to the side by large fat droplets. If you see, this black color structure is the nucleus of the fat cells, and these all are the vacuoles that contain the fat droplets. Right? As it demands, because mast cells are responsible for production of immunoglobulin E, they are for the allergic reactions, and monocytes are also agranulocytes. Jyotsna, I am answering your question. They are the granulocytes that are responsible for allergic reactions, for any inflammatory, any of these reactions when it happens, that can be dealt with reference to monocytes. That's the reason converts into mast cells. There is specified functions. They're totipotent in nature, that way I can tell you. They can do multiple functions. When we talk about reticular network of loose ground substance, they also lie as a network, because reticular means network. Lymphoid organs, bone marrow, spleen. This is the example. This is the structure of a spleen, which is a reservoir for RBC. It is a graveyard of RBC. This is the detailed structure, inner structure of the spleen, which you can see this dark color network like structure. This is the reticular structure, and these globular like structures are the lymphocytes, white blood cells and lymphocytes. When you say dense connective tissue, as I told, they are found in tendons, most ligaments, and they are called as aponeuroses. Wow, that question came here. Sir, what is aponeurosis? Interesting. This is the shoulder joint. This brown color structure is ligament. This is the tendon. And when you say aponeurosis, perfect, Jyotsna. I think Jyotsna answered it. I think spelling somewhere something went wrong. I think Jyotsna. Otherwise, answer is correct. Thank you, my dears, making my job much easy. Making my job much easy. What is that, Jyotsna? SHEARH, shear. Thank you. Thank you. A flat sheet that act as a tendon. Thank you. A flat sheet that act as a, thank you, Jyotsna. Thank you, Tamanna. I am happy, man. My class is very knowledgeable class, man. I am happy about it. They attaches the muscles to bone or to muscles, attaches bone to bone, withstands the great tensile strength and pulling forces applied in one direction because of aponeurosis. Withstands the great tensile stress when pulling forces applied in one direction, that is because of the great tensile strength. In connective tissue proper, primarily irregular arranged collagen fibers, some elastic. Here also fibrous joint capsule, capsules of the organs, joints, dermis of the skin, submucosa of the digestive tract. Sir, only do remember this, understand this location, that is very important. Elastic ones, walls of the large arteries with certain ligaments associated with the vertebral column, within the wall of the bronchial tubules. This is the aorta, this is the heart, where the main pumping, it's the main transmission unit which transmits the blood to entire body. Allows recoil of the tissues following stretching, maintains pulsatile flow of the food through the arteries. When I say flow of the food means blood, it's passive recoil of the lungs following inspiration. When you breathe in or breathe out, anything which has expanded has to recoil. And when this recoiling happens, this recoiling happens because of elastic connective tissue proper. Coming to cartilage, which is very important, there is the hyaline cartilage. You can see this is the matrix and this is the chondrocytes. The best cartilages you can see in the rib cage, that is the costal rib cages. Right? This is the cartilage of a trachea. And that is the reason if you see, sir, why our trachea never collapses. Trachea never collapses because they have cartilaginous ring around the trachea. Because that cartilaginous ring, it never collapses, it never shrinks. Amorphous but firm matrix, collagen fibers form the imperceptible network. Chondroblast produces the matrix when mature, lie in the lacuna. There is a cavities like structure after on maturity. When they are immature, they don't lie, they lie, they move freely. When they mature, they live in the lacuna. Supports and reinforces, has resilient cushioning properties, resist compression, compressive stresses. Yes, Radhika. Forms most of the embryonic skeleton, covers the ends of the long bones in joint cavities, form costal cartilage of the ribs, cartilage of the nose, trachea, larynx. Larynx is the voice box. What is the voice box of bird called as? What is the voice box of bird called as? Yes. What is the voice box of birds called as? The first one was hyaline cartilage. Now moving to elastic cartilage, similar to hyaline cartilage but more elastic fibers in matrix. Hyaline has less, maintains the shape or the structure while allowing great flexibility, supports the external ear pinna and epiglottis. So if question is asked, it is the elastic cartilage that is in the ear pinna, not the hyaline, whereas hyaline cartilage is found in the rib cage, that is costal muscles, whereas in the elastic cartilage it is found in epiglottis and the ears. Fibrocartilage, very important, in between the invertebral column, in between the vertebral column, that is what you call a slip disc. That is what you call it as slip disc, right? And when we say this, it causes slip disc, that is because of fibrocartilage that has stopped functioning, right? Okay, syrinx. Yeah, I think I am getting your comments a little late. I think, yeah. No issues, but I am getting your comments. I am sorry. Yeah. Radhika, Naushin, Smarnika, Jyotsna. Don't worry. I am getting your comments. No issues. Tensile strength with the ability to absorb compressive shocks. Intervertebral disc, pubic symphysis, disc of a knee joint. That's what I told you. Whenever this happens, it's a slip disc. Here you can see the classical example of fibrocartilage. It is like a waves. It's like a waves. Osseous tissues, that's what very commonly this question is asked. The tissues which are responsible for formation of bones. People write osteoclast. The tissues are osseous tissues that makes this bone. Hard calcified matrix containing many collagen fibers. Osteocytes lie in the lacuna, very well vascularized. Huge amount of blood supply and all is there. So we cannot say, you know, it does not happen. Bone supports and protects, provide lever for the muscles to act on, stores calcium and other minerals. Marrow inside the bone is the site for blood cell formation, that is hematopoiesis. Right? So if you see, this is lamella, and if you see here, it looks like the face of a, particularly if you observe one, it looks like a skin of a lion or skin of a tiger. If you see this, looks like it is an eye, and how it looks like central canal, that is lacuna, and another one is lamella. If you see this bone, the transverse section of a bone, this is the humerus bone actually, which is this humerus, which has a head and when you see a cut section, when you cut open it, you will see a marrow. This is the same white color structure. Then inner layer is endosteum, then is a compact bone, and when you cut open it, this layer cut open, the outer layer is called as peristomium, or more importantly called as periosteum. And when you cut open or take a transverse section of it, this periosteum, you will see cytoplasmic process and the nucleus inside. So it is like this. So it is like so it makes a circle sort of thing. And these are called as Haversian canals or Haversian system. Periosteum is the outer layer. It makes the inside dorsal Haversian canals. And discontinuous, a canal like structures are there which is not uniform. Whereas Haversian canals are uniform, they may called as Wachmann's canal. Haversian canals. And this entire system is canal tube within a tube. So when you say tube within a tube, that is Haversian system. So there are only two canals you should remember. One is Wachmann's, another is Haversian. Haversian is continuous, that makes this matrix. If you see this, this is the Haversian canal system, like a spiral ring if you make it. That is Haversian. Whereas columellar is like this, that is Wachmann's canal. Coming to the fluid connective tissue, that is blood, contained within the blood vessels, that is either arteries, veins or capillaries. You can see red blood cells, plasma, neutrophils, lymphocytes, all that. Transport of respiratory gases, that is either oxygen or CO2. Nutrients, waste and other substances, red and white blood cells in the fluid matrix. Fluid matrix is only called as plasma, do remember. Technically, fluid matrix of a blood is called as plasma. Coming to muscular tissues, that is only three type of we have to discuss. This is skeletal muscles, long cylindrical multinucleate cells, obvious striations. This you can see, these are the striations. Multinucleate. When you say multinucleate, earlier also I told that state is called as syncytial, right? Voluntary movement, locomotion, manipulation of the environment, facial expression, voluntary control are done by skeletal muscles. Question over. And I don't think so. I have to tell you what is the difference between voluntary and involuntary. We are studying from 6th standard. In skeletal muscle attached to bone or occasionally to the skin. This is when you say biceps, triceps and all. If you see a muscle fiber or a skeletal muscle, you can see this structure. It has multiple components. And when you say multiple, these are called as fasciculi or fascicles. These fascicles are present in perimysium. Inside the perimysium is our fasciculi. Inside the fasciculi are found endomysium. Endomysium. Getting it? Sir, the fasciculi membrane is called as, membrane of fascicle is called as peri. Peri means outside. Endo means inside. Sir, what about epi? Epi is outside peri. Epicarp. So this is peri. Individual is called as fascicle. Inside it is endo. This is called as epimysium. And inside the fascicle, as I said, it is endomysium. Individual endomysium gives rise to muscle fiber. Cardiac muscles, as it is says, it is near the heart. They have interkelated discs. Striations are there. Nucleus is there. Branching, striated, generally uninucleate, very important. Sir, skeletal muscles are also have striations. Here also striations. Difference is that cardiac muscles are uninucleate, whereas skeletal muscles are multinucleate. As it contracts, it propels blood into the circulation, involuntary control, the walls of the heart. So when I say walls of the heart, it's involuntary, whereas these have voluntary movements, that is skeletal. Smooth muscles, usually found in the walls of the hollow organs. Most of the hollow organs have this. Spindle shaped cells with the central nuclei, no striations, cells arranged closely to form a sheet. So do remember, smooth muscles have no striations. This is a thumb rule. Propel substances or the object, food stuff, urine in a baby along the internal passageway, involuntary control, throwing of a baby also, parturition. Right, before going to nervous tissues, let us do the contest question for that. If a carbon dioxide concentration in blood increases, breathing becomes faster and deep. Many people have answered. Winner is Radhika. Congratulations, Radhika. One atom session is dedicated to you, is given to you. Hearty congratulations. Right. I think most of the people who have answered, all of them have given the correct answer. And now today's contest question, for which time is only 30 seconds. Very simple question, Tamanna. Camel's hump is made up of dash tissue. You have to give the specific name of the tissue. Camel's hump is made up of dash tissue. Name the tissue. Camel, you might have seen a hump in which they say he stores water. Yes, I need the answer. Six, five, four, three, is keep giving the answers, keep attempting it. Okay, coming to nervous tissues or the neurons, they are the longest, fully differentiated. They cannot be de-differentiated or re-differentiated. They are fully differentiated once for all. Neurons are the branching cells, cell process that may be quite long, extend from the nucleus containing cell body, also contributing to nervous tissues, non-irritable supporting cells, non-illustrated. So it is made up of, neural process is made up of two things. One is a neural process, that is axon, and another is cell body. So when you say these are the dendrites, yellow color structure that you see is dendrite nucleus. This makes something called as cell body. The nosheen, in case of whale, it is a blubber. It is a type of yes. And functions transmit electrical signals from sensory receptors and effectors, muscles and glands, which control their activities, brain, spinal cord, nerves. That is the reason there is conduction, that is signal conduction across, right? So in case of neurons, when you say the most important thing, the sheaths are present. These sheaths, if they are present, we call it as myelinated sheath, and it is called as myelinated neuron. If it is non-sheath is not present, it is called as amyelinated or non-myelinated. This is the dendrites. This is the nucleus. So what happens? The dendrite of one is attached to basement membrane or the tail fibers. So this is the dendrite. It goes to another neuron, another neuron. So as a result, there is a continuous flow of signal. Signal continuously flows. And when this signal flows, there is a nerve conduction across the membrane of, that is called as neurilemma. Do remember, in case of muscles also it happens. It is sarcomere. Sir, what is the importance of glial tissues in the nervous tissues? Glial tissues are the storage tissues. They store the signals, and if glial cells are not working, person suffer from Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. Glial tissues are responsible for signaling, storing the signals, like what you do in your capacitor. It stores the charge. Same way glial cells does the same thing. So what happens? There is a conduction, and when this conduction happens, they undergo polarization to repolarization to depolarization. Why I'm not telling in detail, I'm just giving you a nutshell. And many a times these electric signals are under the control of enzymes, and more importantly with endocrine glands. Enzymes and endocrine glands. And once these enzymes and endocrine glands, they play, they move, they're neurotransmitters comes and play, melatonin and serotonin. These are the two prominent neurotransmitters which help. And do remember, when this signal goes to another axon, there is a synapse. There is a synapse. And this is the synapse that is happening because of presence of calcium. Calcium is responsible for making this synapse or the complete conduction. That is calcium dependent, right? So detail you will do when we will do the nervous system. So sir, what all things we have done? We have done about the connective tissue, starting from the blood to the bone to the cartilage. Muscular tissues, we talked about sarcomeres, the membrane or the layer of the sarcomeres. Neural tissues, axon and cyton, that is what we have done, right? So hope only fact based questions will be asked, hardly any analytical question is asked from here. So please do solve the question of CPP. There are out of 10 questions, 3 questions we will find it very difficult. I knowingly I have put it and have dug for that to find the answers. So sweat out, do work, and see you soon next time. Till then, take care of your good health. May God bless you all. Shubh Ratri, Shabba Khair.